introduction in 3, 2, 1. Intro is now happening right here. You always wanted to know about Mr. Money Mustache, and in this video, I'm gonna go over the good, the bad, and the ugly of Mr. Money Mustache. Let's get into it. Mr. Money Mustache, otherwise known as Pete, is a blogger and one of the original leaders of the financial independence movement. Oh yeah, and he retired when he was only 30 years old. I've been a reader of Mr. Money Mustache's blog for over 10 years. But before I get into that, I'm giving away a copy of this book here, Quit Like a Millionaire. It's an awesome book. I just finished reading it and I'm gonna give this away, but in order to find out how to win it, you have to hang around to the end of the video where I'll tell you what you need to do in order to win this book. So let's start off with the good about Mr. Money Mustache. Now, one of the most amazing shifts that's happened that isn't really talked about is consumerism. And it started with the explosion of the middle class and particularly the explosion of shopping malls in the US. By 1986, there were more shopping malls in the US than there were high schools. And this created the rise of something that we call affluenza. Oh my God. And no, it's not the flu. Maybe I have the flu, jeez. Affluenza, as defined by the Merriam-Webster Dictionary, means extreme materialism and consumerism associated with the pursuit of wealth and success and resulting in a life of chronic dissatisfaction, debt, overwork, stress, and impaired relationships. And social media has obviously enhanced this disease that we have with blind spending and perpetual unhappiness just trying to keep up with the Joneses and wherever they're traveling to on Instagram. Mr. Money Mustache's advice primarily focuses on addressing affluenza that resides inside all of us. And there's actually a like super old retro 90s movie that was done on affluenza, which I'll link to up here if you guys wanna watch it. It's really good, but like also super corny too. I highly recommend it, check it out. Pete, or Mr. Money Mustache, preaches about focusing on cutting your spending and really learning about what truly makes you happy in life. He also practices what he preaches, and he's cut his family expenses down to below $30,000 for the average year. And he really likes to highlight and focus on how doing this will exponentially increase your savings rate, allowing you to retire extremely early, like Pete did at 30. And all of his advice is completely true and very important for us to learn. And he has by far more ways to save money and cost savings than anyone else I know. So now let's get into the bad advice from Mr. Money Mustache. Now, I don't really think there's necessarily bad advice from Mr. Money Mustache. However, I think it lacks the clarity and context for how it fits in with the rest of your financial picture. And your financial picture looks like this. Income minus expenses multiplied by investments equals your financial picture. While Mr. Money Mustache focuses on primarily how to just reduce your expenses, it's important to know that you can get the same, maybe even better results by also learning how to increase your income and how to properly invest for the way that suits your life. All right, so now let's get into the ugly advice. Now, putting aside the slightly culty aspects, which I secretly want to be a part of, I have been hearing and reading lots of stories of people who have followed down his path of extreme frugality. And so many people going down that path have found that they've just become absorbed by the numbers and have forgotten how to live a happy and fulfilled life. They just become laser focused on that destination of financial independence that's usually far off in the future for most of us. I've even heard of some people suffering severe depression after they have achieved financial independence. So when they don't have to work anymore. And that's something that we don't want us to happen. That's you and me. We don't want that to happen to us. So please don't take this as an excuse to ignore Mr. Money Mustache's advice. I assure you there's tons of unnecessary spending in your life and still in my life. However, I don't think our time is best spent finding the grocery store with the cheapest avocados. I mean, they're not mojitos, but I still really love avocados. Instead, make sure you do the following. Number one, take suggestions from Mr. Money Mustache that works for your life. Number two, still try to cut as many costs as you can, but also learn to become conscious about your spending. Number three, learn other parts of the financial picture. That includes learn how to increase your income and learn how to properly invest. And number four, find what works best for you for each variable in the financial picture. Starting a big internet company might not be your thing, but making an extra 500 bucks a month serving mojitos at your favorite beach, that might be your thing. There's a reason I call it personal finances, because it's personal. What works for you is not the same and what's gonna work for me. So learn all you can and focus on the aspects that you want to when it comes to saving, income, and investments. And not just that, but you can learn all of those things by subscribing to my YouTube channel in this corner here. It's definitely in this corner this time, right? So now what hopefully a lot of you have been waiting for, how to win this book, How to Quit Like a Millionaire. So to win this book, I want you to comment on this video and let me know what aspect of your financial picture that you want to focus on the most. Is it learning how to decrease your costs? What costs? Your housing, your food? Or is it learning how to increase your income more? I want to know in the comments below, and by commenting, you'll be entered in a chance to win this book, which I'll announce on my next video. That's it for me, everybody. So I hope you all have a great weekend, and I look forward to seeing your beautiful faces next week. Peace out.